Today we are going to discuss the chapter number 20, that is your direct and indirect speech. Basically, in this chapter I will explain you how you can change the statement from direct to indirect, what are the rules you have to follow, all right? And for that you need to understand how we frame the statement, what are the features of the direct and indirect. So let's go with your book. First of all, you see the following sentence has been given in your book. Ritu said the Taj Mahal was built on the bank of river Yamuna long ago and it still attracts tourists to Agra. So this is in the direct speech, because we follow here the person is speaking and the spoken words are in the within the inverted comma and the actual words are there. All right. Now come to the indirect speech. The same thing has been repeated over here. Roma said that she had to reach home as soon as possible because her mother was not well. So this is not in the direct speech because the spoken words are not the actual word. Okay, just you see, sentence A is in direct speech because the exact words of the speaker Ritu are reported here. So this is the exact word which has been explained or printed here in your book. So that is why it is called here direct speech. All right, inverted commas have been used to indicate the spoken word. So all these actual word up to here, it is within the inverted comma. We also call it quotation. All right, now sentence B. So here you need to understand what is the direct speech. In the indirect speech, we report the word of a speaker by repeating the actual words which are indicated with the help of inverted commas. So first feature of the direct speech is that the spoken word, the actual word will be in the within the inverted comma. This is the basic feature of the direct statement. Now in sentence B, as it is in the reported speech, okay, so it is in the reported speech because it does not convey the exact words of the speaker Roma, and no inverted comma have been used here. So here in sentence B you see there is no inverted comma here. So this is what in the indirect form, because the actual word is not the same word. Okay, the substance may be the same, meaning may be the same, but the spoken words are not actual. So when we convey the speaker's thought without repeating the actual word, but the substance of the word used by the speaker, it is called the reported or indirect speech or narration. So this is what here I have explained you about the direct and indirect. Now let us see the comparison. What are the basic features of the direct and indirect? Inverted commas are used to enclose the exact words of the speaker in the direct speech. You see here, these are the inverted comma and the spoken words are within the inverted comma. That is, Vinnie said, I have a holiday tomorrow. Alright, so this is direct speech. But in the indirect speech, there will be no inverted comma. Alright, so the teacher told me to go home. Then a comma is used after the introductory or a reportive verb. So you will notice that after the person who is speaking, there is one comma. Like here you see, this is a reporting verb, mother said, and after this there is one comma, and then we start the statement or the spoken word, and that also in the within the inverted comma. We finish the statement with the full stop and the capital. We start the sentence with a capital and end it with a full stop. But here in the indirect speech, you will see comma is not used after the introductory or a reporting verb, but that is used, it is in its place. Sometimes that is not written, only understood. So that is a conjunction word which we are using to relate the reporting verb to the speech. All right. So sometimes that is also not required. For example, she said she would watch a movie with us. So here that is not necessary. She said that, we can use that also, but it is not required. We can skip for that. Now coming to the C number, punctuation mark, like question marks, exclamation mark, commas are used. So according to the demand of the statement, we will use a certain expression. Alright, so Suruchi said, after the reporting verb, we have applied one comma, then the inverted comma starts. Wow, such a lovely gift. So this is your exclamatory sentence. So we have followed the rules of the exclamatory form of the statement. We have completed with the full stop and close this inverted comma. Now all the punctuation mark are removed except commas and full stop, but these we do not follow for the indirect. Here we do not follow any punctuation in the indirect speech. All right, so the Suruchi exclaimed with joy that it was a lovely gift. So there is no exclamatory mark, nothing is expressed with the punctuation. Alright, now coming to the indirect speech, a conjunction, if required, is used to join the reported speech with the rest of the sentence. Example, Hari said that he was down with the fever. So this is the conjunction word which we join the first part reported verb with the speech. So this is the very important part. Plus, tenses, personal pronoun like I, we, you, she, her, possessive adjective like my, your, his, her, an adverb indicating nearness of time and place change when direct speech is converted into indirect speech. For example, the lady said to him. So here you will see how there is a change of pronoun. Okay, I am glad that you completed your work. This is the direct form of a speech. Now how it is written or expressed in the indirect? The lady told him that she was. So this I has changed into what? She was glad that he, now you has changed into he, had completed his work. So this is how we change the pronoun. Now let's go with some rules of the direct and indirect, which will help you to understand the change of the statement. All right. First of all, you should remember that when the reported verb is in the present or the future form, there is no change in the speech. Alright, so we are going with one of the example of the future form. When the reporting verb is in the present tense or the future, so Meher says, now this is in the present form because Meher says is the present form reported verb. Now I will buy the tickets now. So this is the reported speech. There will be no change when this is in the present form. This part, when it is in the present form, there will be no change. So Meher says that she will buy the ticket now. So there is no change in the same word will be copied in the indirect format. Now second number, you see, when the reported speech state universal truth or habitual action. So when there is a universal truth, when there is no change in the nature or your habitual action, so the same will continue for your indirect form also. For example, Mr. Holmes said the earth moves round the sun. So this is I am following the inverted comma capital. We are starting the statement with the capital, ending with the full stop, completing it. This is how the direct speech. Now indirect form, Mr. Holmes said that, the same thing will be copied here down because this is the universal truth. Said that the earth moves around the sun. Now next is your, when the reported speech is in the present tense, the same thing I have explained here. The same thing is here. One more example is for you. The girl says, I am eating porridge. So the same sentence will be here. The girl says that she is eating porridge. The same will continue with the future form also. If the girl will say, okay, in that way. So again, it will be continued in the same manner. All right. Now let us see in what form we change the statement or the change of tense. When the reported verb in the simple present tense, it changes into simple past tense. For example, you see, she said, this is in the reported verb is in the past tense and the reported speech. Okay, so now this is in which tense? It is in the present tense. So when the reported speech is in the present tense, so the speech changes into past tense. So I eat vegetables for lunch. So this is how the statement changes. She said that she ate vegetables for lunch. So eat has changed into ate. Simple present has changed into simple past. So when we are doing these changes, when our reported speech, this format is in the present tense, it will change into simple past. She, I eat vegetable for lunch. So I has changed, the pronoun has changed I into she, and eat has changed into ate. So this is a very simple rule that when the reported speech is in the simple present tense, it will change into past tense. Now again, you will see, when the reported speech is in the present continuous tense, it will change into past continuous. They said, we are playing football. So this I will copy here again down. They said that, this is a conjunction. They said that, since it is we, so I will change into pronoun, that is they. They said that they were. So we are has changed into they were. This is your past continuous. They were playing football. So this is how present continuous has changed into past continuous. Now next is your simple past tense. So that changes into past perfect tense. Rhea said, I went to the show. So next will be what? The same the statement, it is already in the past form. So the past form will change into past perfect. We will apply had here. So Rhea said that she had gone to the show. This is how we have changed the statement. Now next is your the past continuous tense. All right, so that changes into past perfect continuous. Like for example, Jim and Julie said we were dancing. So this will change into Tim and Julie said that they had been dancing. So this is the past perfect. They plus had plus been. All right. Then your number 5, the past perfect and past perfect continuous tenses, there are no change. When the reported speech is in the past perfect, there will be no change of statement in the your reported speech. So for example, Derek said, I had gone to the zoo. So there will be no change. Derek said that he had gone to the zoo. There will be no change because this is already in the past perfect. So there will be no change. Now some specific changes that we follow in the statement or the rules are that shall changes into should, will changes into would, must into had to, can into could, may into might. So this is what some notes, some important point that I have explained you. When you go through the books, you will get various example regarding it. All right. So some examples I'm just reading for you. Here it's given there. For example, you see, Anu said to him, this is the reported verb, the boys are not late. So this is in the present tense. This speech is in the present tense. So Anu told him that the boys were not late. So present tense has changed into simple past form. Present, simple present change into simple past form. Then father said, Rina has come. So this is in the present perfect. All right. So here this is change. This changes into past perfect. Father said that Rina had come. Now mother said Bindu had left. Mother said that the Bindu had left. So this is the past perfect already. There will be no change. The teacher said the students were late for the class. So this is a past. So that has changed into past perfect. The teacher said that the students had been late for the class. Then number 5, the teacher said the boy was injured. This is the simple past. Okay. So that simple past will change into past perfect. The teacher said that the boy had been injured. Number 6, Meena said the packets has been distributed. So which tense this is? This is your in your simple present. This is the present perfect tense. So has been is there. So that will change into had been. Has been changed into had been. So Meena said that the packets had been distributed. All right. Then Mithali said the plumber did the work well. So that will change into Mithali said that the plumber had done the work well. Piyu said Neha can come if she keeps well. So I have explained you how these are changing. So Piyu said that Neha could come if she kept well. So these are some of the example which I have explained you. Now some more I would like to explain you the change of pronoun that you can see how it is changing. She said I enjoy listening to music. So this is a subject reporting verb. Okay. Then she said that she, this person I is who? She. She said that she enjoyed listening to music. This is how we changes. So I is the first person pronoun here and changes to she. Now in the second case, he said I like to read books. So this I stands for whom? He. So he said that he like to read books. I changes, this is what I changes to he. So this is some example which I have explained you for the pronoun. Now some of the statement for the other forms, let us go with that. In your book it is given at the page number 163. So this is what it changes. Tomorrow changes to next day. Yesterday changes to the day before or the previous day. Tonight changes to that night. Today changes to that day. This into that. These into those. Next day to the following day. Last week, the previous week. Here will be in the form of there. Ago will be changed into before. Alright, this is how we are going to make a change when it is required in the statement. Alright, now changing of the type of sentence into indirect speech, there are some more example given there accordingly. Kindly go through the example and you can solve all the examples or exercises which is given in your book. The answers had already, the assignment has already been given to you. Go through all the example and understand the chapter. Thank you.